We successfully located the leak, hydraulic leak without any visible leaks. Yeah, and this video I'm going to show you how to remove this swing motor. As you can see, there's no hydraulic oil on a 10 gauge present, and where it's going, it's all went down inside the slew ring tub. And a question number two, what is leaking? And yeah, swing motor pinion gear seal is leaking when you pull the dipstick out, and you only should see the gear oil, see the lower and upper marks, and we're way higher, and that's all hydraulic oil. Yeah, we have to fix it. Let's pull that swing motor out and see what's inside. And inside this slew ring we have gallons and gallons of hydraulic oil mixed with the grease and the gear oil, all kind of mess. Yeah, that's the work for today, and here we go, we have the swing motor pulled out, and this video is only a demonstration how I do it. Might be helpful to someone. That's a big pinion gear. Let's get started. We have 2054 hydraulic road builder excavator today. Before starting disconnecting hydraulic lines, let's release the hydraulic pressure. Beautiful, no pressure. If you're first time to the channel, please take a second to subscribe. Thank you so much. Yeah, and click the notification bell, that way you won't miss any interesting new videos. Yeah. Next, I'm going to remove the upper step cover plate to get access to our swing motor, and then we'll keep working on the hydraulics. We have some electrical connectors down to it. The step plate is removed. Now we can see everything. Yeah, easy, lots of room. I like the design, not that crowded. And one very important part, when you step down into the pit, just watch where you're stepping on. Always watch your step. You don't want to step on the harnesses, electrical connectors, and some light pilot lines. Those big power lines you won't break, but watch for tiny little hydraulic fittings, because I saw a few times when someone's trying to fix it, one thing, step on a wiring harness, break the connector, solenoid. Yeah, just be careful where you step, and yeah, when you're fixing one thing, don't want to break something else. Before disconnecting the hydraulic hoses, I'm going to wash the fittings with just a brake clean. Yeah, a little bit grease and gunk. Don't need to. Something like that, good enough. At least keep it as clean as possible. You don't want any dirt get inside, even if it needs to be. Yeah, way better. All right, now it's clean. Good enough. Over here we have two lines, same diameter, coming from the same side, and we have a port A and port B, and I marked the lines with a colorful zip ties. This one's orange, this one's yellow, and I know A corresponds to yellow and B corresponds to orange. I like to take a picture before tearing everything apart. Here we go, and that way I know for sure how it was assembled. It will take a while for the motor to get resealed, and that way I don't have to guess. No guessing, no for sure, everything was assembled. Beautiful. Okay, there's only one electrical connector on the bottom. Let's disconnect that guy. It's a three wire sensor, the pressure sensor. Okay, sounds good. And put this piggy tail away, make sure it won't get damaged when we're lifting the motor up. Here I have two flat face flanges fittings. One undo those ones, two at the top and one on the side. Yeah, pretty straightforward. I have my plugs ready and yeah, tools are here. Let's disconnect all the hydraulic stuff. Kawasaki Precision Machinery. There's a type number, all information, made in Japan, in Nippon. Yeah. John Deere is using Kawasaki parts and also Hitachi pumps. Yeah, that's the way it is. One step at a time, as usual. Okay, all hydraulic lines are disconnected, all ports are capped. Same on a hydraulic hose side. Keep everything clean. Alright, good enough. Time for the bolts. We have 12 bolts all the way around the swing motor. Bolts are inch and 3/16 head. Yeah, inch and 3/16 socket. I'm going to use 3/4 drive. And I have a ratchet here and a pipe for the leverage. If this video is helpful, put a thumbs up. And if you have any comments, critics, suggestions, recommendations, concerns, put everything down in the comment section below under the video. Thank you so much for doing that. Okay. Now the socket won't go anywhere. Nice. Before pulling the motor out, remember the orientation. It's pretty obvious, pretty simple. And if you look in the bottom, there's a hole in the housing and there's a drain. Yeah, make sure it's all aligned. Yeah, pretty straightforward. It's pretty hard to put it the wrong way. Oh yeah, oh, baby.
Oh my God, so much easier on me.
Success! I got all bolts broken loose. Now I can really take them out by hand like that, nice and easy. They're pretty tight, but with a long enough extension, you can get them out.
M20 bolts.
Nice. And yeah, I see the fluid inside the. Archimedes said, give me long enough extension and I can flip the earth, which is true. Yeah, all right, I'm going to remove all of them and then we'll get set up for lift. Here we go, all mounting bolts are removed one by one and we're ready for the lift, almost. Here's the one. Two threaded holes and we're going to use the flange bolts to get our chain hooked up like that. As you can see, the bolts are too small, heads will go through the link. What I'm going to do, I'm just going to use the washers like that and I'll put one here, start it, and another one on another opposite side. And this chain will stay until we'll be ready to put it back. Here we go. Let's tie the ball down. Face it out like that. It can hang freely. Snag it a little bit. Nice. And this one, same way. Good enough, tight, and we're ready to lift. Swing motor is removed successfully. Time to do the cleanup later, fix that leak, and put it back, and we should be good. Yeah, simple as it is. As you can see, lots of yogurt that mixed hydraulic oil with the gear oil on the bottom of the slew ring. Look at that gear. Massive, yeah.
We're still working on 2054D hydraulic excavator. Let me show you everything. Rebuild good hydraulic swing motor is installed, everything's in place, all bolts are tightened and torqued, hydraulic lines are connected. All new O-rings. I have that one little electrical connector connected. To make the installation going nice and easy, there's a few things to watch. There's a one pin over there, and another pin is over there on the opposite side, and a drain cock facing that opening. Make sure it's everything's aligned first. Of course, you clean everything, clean the surfaces, threads, all prep. And then when you start dropping the swing motor, the pinion gear might be slightly off the initial position when you pull it out. And your ring gear might not kind of slide be in the right spot. And the motor will drop, but on one side, it might stay a little bit on an angle. And how to get it fixed, how to get it all the way in and down. What I did, I used another excavator to push a little bit on one corner of the machine and then go to another just a little bit, couple inches in and out, and that way your house will rotate and teeth will align and you will feel that it will drop in fully. And that means you found the sweet spot. Just give a little turn. That's very important. And then you can start all bolts by hand and follow your service repair manual for all specs. from the hydraulic shop. Swing motor came with no oil. I filled up a gear oil and we're right at the top mark. Fresh oil. And after the first 150 hours of operation, we'll have to change the oil, and then second change will be after 800 hours, and we should be good to go. Always maintain the proper level, make sure swing motor is not leaking, overheating, just keep eye on it. Top it up, hydraulic oil. Now we're in a safe zone and we have pretty much everything ready to start the machine. Make a few nice turns and swing back and forth. I'm going to clean all my tools and ready to start the engine. There you go, our oil fluids are good and we're ready to start. Glow plugs good, and we have 14,644.9 hours. It's quite a bit, and it's the first time that bad boy started to leak from the pinion shaft seal. All right, let's crank it. Poof, beautiful. I always let the engine to warm up for a minute. Outside is pretty warm. Get the oil, go up to the head, and yeah, let's just move the machine over there where's the open area, and yeah, swing it. Okay. Raise the RPM, lock, lift our pump. There we go. Let's turn a little bit, and we're turning. All good. Let's back up. And then we go forward. Okay, now we have tons of room to swing full circle and then go out and check for leaks. And we're turning. Oh yeah. We're turning. Let's go another way. Don't want to put a load yet. Just a nice light turn. Yeah, we're turning, turning, turning. Nice. All right. Outside, checked for leaks. We'll keep eye on it for a little while because they might show up. They shouldn't, but you never know. Well, let's go up again and check what we have. We'll look for any leaks. Check the gear oil level. Put it back. Beautiful. Right at the top mark. Nice and clean, fresh gear oil. Good. I have to top it up with hydraulic oil. Bring it up to the middle over there. Our pump took some and we have some oil circulated in the system. Beautiful. Don't forget to grease your ring gear. On this machine is only one grease nipple. It means you have to rotate every 90 degrees and grease it. And don't over-grease it. Don't wanna too much. Thank you so much for your time watching this video. Yeah, appreciated that. Take care. Bye-bye.